Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have did about Cook's homologous series and we have also did Dovinier's trait, and on which we have got a information that they have played a very important role in a formation of periodic table that we are observing nowadays. But let me talk about the Newland's octave also. Even that has played a very important role in arranging those kind of elements in a particular horizontal row. So let us talk about that also. So talking about Newland's law of octaves, what does it say? That Newland found that if the elements were arranged in increasing order of their atomic weights, the properties of every eighth element, that is the property of every eighth element, were similar to those of the first element. So, and this kind of law that they have mentioned or they have arranged, this kind of thing is basically known as Newland's law of octaves. So what does this mean? Let me give you a short example of this thing. So as we have said that the according to Newland's octave, the eighth element will have the similar property with that of the first element. So let me give a short example of that. These are the elements that have been arranged from horizontally, as you could see, and that is starting from the lithium, that is beryllium, boron, carbon, and it goes on. So what it has been observed that the lithium, barium, boron, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, and fluorine, they have a particular atomic weight, as you could see, like 7, 9, 11, 12, 14, 16, 19. But talking about the next group that we have, or the next group of elements that we have, starting from sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, and chlorine atom. So if we would observe that this lithium, suppose if it is the first element, then according to it, the eighth element will be like this one. If it is considered to be 1, this would be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. While the eighth element would be again here, it will come to the sodium. So since this lithium is the first element, and according to this Newland's octave, sodium would be the eighth element. So it has been easily for us to understand that the lithium and the sodium will have the same chemical property, and moreover it has also been found that the lithium and sodium, they are present in the same group in periodic table. So therefore this lithium and this sodium will have the same kind of chemical property. So this was shown by the Newland's octave, the law of Newland's octave. Talking about the beryllium, even beryllium, suppose if we consider this to be the first element, so therefore this is the first, boron with the second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, and all this would be the eighth. So therefore beryllium and magnesium, this are the first and the eighth element when we increase the atomic number from left to right, or in the periodic table, or according to the Newland's octave. So this beryllium and this magnesium are the first and the eighth element, and hence they have similar property. So the first and the eighth element have similar property. So this is valid up to this much only, that is up to calcium only. We could take any one of as a as considered as the first element. So in this case, if I'm talking about the magnesium, and if this is magnesium is the first element, then the eighth element would be the calcium. So therefore this is valid up till calcium only. And moreover, what we have observed is that we didn't observe the heliums or helium, neon, or those kind of noble gases, because this Newland's octave is only applicable till calcium, as well as it is not applicable to the noble gases, and that's the reason we can't find noble gases as the eighth element. Because as we know in periodic table that lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, and after that a noble gas appears, but here the noble gas has no, means the Newland's octave is not validated to the noble gases, and by which it has a few limitations, and up till it is only applicable up till calcium only, but there are more than 180 elements. So therefore this was the Newland's octave, and which had played a very vital role in understanding the arrangement of the elements in a periodic table, and after that this had played a very important role in the formation of the modern periodic table. So this is what the importance of Newland's octave. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this concept very clearly, and you'll share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.